Every time someone must make a decision, time and effort must be used and the positive and negative aspects of each of the possible actions must be considered. However, when a flight crew faces these situations, the time factor is extremely limited. Every time a flight crew faces a complex scenario, whether due to a passenger problem such as a medical emergency or a technical failure of the plane, they must carry out, in a very short time, a series of actions and analyze many factors to make a correct decision. Making a decision in times of crisis, where we will be affected by the startle effect, fear, nervousness and lack of time is very difficult, and most people will be confused. To carry out this process of making a good decision, decision-making models have been created that are a guide that helps to consider the most important aspects of a given problem. There are several models in the aeronautical world. They are all acronyms whose letters represent a step in the process. These models can assist flight crews, however, they must have good technical training and pilot expertise to function properly. Now, let us see an example, the T-DODAR model. This model is made up of the following elements. The T stands for time and reminds pilots to consider the time available before executing the decision process. D stands for diagnosis, what is the problem? Make a diagnosis using all available resources and different opinions. The O stands for options, analyze your options, usually related to continue, divert or return. This should be done taking into account all the opinions and uncertainty of crew members. Is in this step where you analyze weather, fuel available, terrain, NOTAMs, performance, etc. D stands for decide, make a decision. Always explain the reason for a decision and remember that any decision can be changed. The A stands for act and assign. Act on your best options and assign tasks that share the workload. The R stands for review. Ask yourself, what is the best decision? Do I forget something? Did any of the factors change? If necessary, you can go back to the beginning and start the decision-making model again. Now you know the importance of applying a decision-making model. Which one will you use?